In the previous video, we dealt with single and double precision numbers, in other words, dealing with floating point numbers. In this video, we're going to talk about two additional data types, the char and also the Boolean. So let's make a start. So we're going to create a new project. I'm going to click on Java, as I've done in the last few videos now. Create project, make sure command line up is selected. I'm going to call this char, C-H-A-R, and Boolean, B-O-O-L-E-A-N. Company name, I'm going to make that Timbuchaka again, com.timbuchaka, but you can make that whatever you want. Click on finish. And I'll just double click that to make it more space, and let's get started. So the two other data types we're going to talk about in this video are char and Boolean. So firstly, char, you define it as my char equals, and you can put a single quote there and a number or a letter, like so. So that's one way. It can literally store one letter or one character. You can also have a lowercase number. You can also mark it as a number, and you can even make it a special character, ampersands and so on. But what you can't do is make it more than one. So we can't put two numbers in there because we get an error. And the error is too many characters in character literal. So it can literally only be one character. It's actually a width of 16, so it's actually 2 bytes. So that's the standard characters that I've been typing in there. But you can also put what's called Unicode characters. And they are special characters that support multiple languages. Just to show this to you, I've got a website I'm going to just go to. I'm going to Google Chrome. I'm going to go to a website called unicode-table.com. And you can see I've just got /en/#control-character on the end. This gives us a list of what's called Unicode characters. So Java also lets us assign a variable of data type char using a special code that I'm going to show you how to do. So you can notice that the Unicode table has got our regular numbers and letters and so forth and special characters like a percent sign, a dollar sign. But as we scroll down, they've got lots of other characters as well. For example, a copyright symbol and all these other accented letters, and the list goes on. There's quite a few of them. So we could choose one, and what we need to do to choose one, we need to start to the left-hand side. So let's just assume we want to use the copyright character. So we start 00A, then we move over to the character, move over to the table element position, in this case 9. So we enter the value we need is 00A9. So we're starting on row 00A, moving right across to 9. So 00A9 is the code that we need. And if we go back to Java, what we can do is we can put a backslash. It has to go that way. And then we put a lowercase u. Then we can type 00A in uppercase 9. Now that's what's called a Unicode character. So if we now do a printout, let's run that. And you can see there that the character has been outputted as a copyright symbol. So the actual range of a char is a width of 16. Width of 16, which effectively is 2 bytes. So that's the amount that has been allocated for a char. Second type is called a Boolean. So we'd use that, we type in Boolean, B-O-O-L-E-A-N. My Boolean equals, and there can only be two values. The two values are true or false. That's it. You can't have any other value for a Boolean, and it's used to test whether something is true or false. So it's really good for that, and you'll see that Booleans are very popular and used a lot for conditional logic, which we'll be talking about in future videos. Probably the way you'd use a Boolean, you'd do something like Boolean is male equals true. The variable name is asking a question, then the value will be whatever the answer is set to. So in this case, we're saying, is it a male as the variable name, and we're signing the value of true. But we'll be talking more about those in detail in a future video. So it's challenge time again. So the challenge for this video is to find the code for the registered symbol on the same line as the copyright symbol on the web page that I've shown you. And incidentally, that website is in the resources section of the video, so you can click over into the resources section to find that link, or I'm going to go back and show you that on the page now if you want to write it down. So you need to find the code for the registered symbol, and that's the symbol that is very much like a copyright with a C in the middle, but it's actually got an R. You then need to create a variable of type char and assign it the Unicode value for that symbol and then display it on the screen. So follow the three steps as I've shown on the screen, find the code, create a new variable of type char and assign it the Unicode value for that registered symbol, then display it on the screen. Okay, pause the video, do that, come back when you're ready and I'll show you my solution. So how did you go? Did you manage to figure it out? Well, the code, going back to the browser first, we start off on 00A and in this case, the R matches up with the E. So we've got to put an E on the end. So where we used a 9 for the copyright symbol, you come over here and it's an E. And did you notice that? I didn't show you before, but if you actually hover over there, it actually gives you the code 00AE, as you can see. So our code is going to be 00AE. So go back to our code. We're going to put char registered symbol equals backslash lowercase u 00AE. Semicolon on the end, and just to print it out, registered symbol equals registered symbol. And that's it, that's the solution. So if we run that just to confirm, and you can see we've now got a registered symbol, which is below the copyright symbol, which of course is still printing above that. So that's it for the char and the Boolean types. In the next video, we're just going to have a bit of a recap on the 8 data types that we've covered to date. They were called primitive types, and I'll be just explaining what that means. And then we're going to move on to another data type, a special data type. We're going to be looking at that in the next, and that's called string. And we're going to also be looking at that in the next video.